Hello everybody. Today we are going to make washcloth baby rose bouquets and baby sock rose bouquets. I went to Ross's and I got a 12 pack of washcloths for $3.99. Six pairs of socks for $3.99. So that'll end up making a dozen roses right there. Two dozen for the total. You will need painted stem wires. I picked this up at Walmart. And floral tape, self-adhesive or self-sealing rather. I've decided that I don't want my roses very tall because I don't want the centerpieces to be so tall that people can't conversate without seeing one another. So I cut the entire thing in half. So let's see, they were 18 inches, so they're 9 inches now. And you'll need a pair of scissors and a wire cutters to do that. Anyway, let's get started. I think I'm going to get rid of this little tag because I'm sure the mama would also. You'll take one of the little washcloths, fold it in half, and fold it in half again. Now you're gonna roll it up, but what you wanna do is you wanna do it at an angle so that you leave a little bit of the top. Let me see if I can't get you in here. I'm gonna leave the top at an angle so it ends up giving you a rose feel to it. And as you're rolling, we're going to insert the them right there. Let's see. And continue rolling till you get the end of it. There you go. Now you start with the floral tape about halfway, or about half an inch rather, I'm sorry, halfway around the bottom, and just once you pull it, it starts to adhere to itself. So go ahead and continue all the way down until you get to the bottom of it, and then you start on the stem wire. Make sure that it will stay put. I'm probably going to do this one more time because it is rather a big bulge to be hanging there. So one more time going around. Make sure that it's going to stay put. And there you go. And so now that we've done the washcloth, I'm going to move on to the sock. Okay, here we go with the baby sock. You're going to use the same stuff. I bought a sock that has little tags on the side. Okay. It doesn't matter if the sock, the toe goes to the left or to the right. I guess it's just your preference. And so what you're going to do is you're going to turn up about maybe 3/4 to an inch up and in. And then you're going to roll. 1, 2, 3 rolls. And then you take this the open part of the sock and you turn it in and up and see where I told you the little taggy thingy is sort of interfering, but we're gonna kind of play with that. And this is what you're left with, a little baby tiny itty bitty little baby rose. You can kind of play with it and get it to how you want it to look. See, it is really kind of cute. Oops, that's not the long one. And then once again, let me flatten this because the cut made it a little bendy. Don't want to cut, poke the little socks. So then you'll just go ahead and, like the last one, you'll go ahead and insert it. We'll make sure that we get it in there. And once again, with the floral tape, hold it tight, wrap it around, and keep wrapping until you're on the stem. This is not being cooperative. And there you go, home free. And then once again, add some silk leaves. Let's go ahead and rearrange this so that it's how we want it to look. I think next time I will go ahead and redo it. But there you go, little baby socks and little washcloths. And when I get this all done and I have it ready in the container, I'll come back and give you a finale shot. Very simple, very cute. This is the satin leaves. The lighting is really bad, but anyway, it was a gross for $5.49. There you go. Okay, this is the finished flower with the silk leaves added, and I added in quite a few of them together to make a bouquet, and we'll stick them in a vase. So you have the washcloths and the stockings. Start again. Since that was such a short craft, I decided to throw in another one. It's one that I've already done, but I did it while I was vlogging, so I want to do this as a true craft. At every shower, you have to use pens to play some of the games, and I decided it would be very neat to do some pretty pens. So what you'll need is some flowers, a straight pen that, you know, what are they called? It's just got to be round. It can't have any part of it that, you know, comes to a point. And it has to be flat with a cap because you can't have the type that clicks like this. And you'll need floral tape. So what you'll do, that was a mini pen, so we'll just use a regular size pen. And my cat has decided to sit right in front of me. But you get your wire clippers because these flowers have wires in the stem. And you clip perhaps an inch in from the top of it. Then you're going to place, I like to see if it will go up a little further, I like to do that, but I just place it right to the edge of the pen, and it will look like that. You're holding it up against the side of it, and you get your floral tape. Again, such an incredibly simple craft, and the ladies will be fighting over which pen they want to keep. I'm serious. I used to make these as just, you know, cute little gifts to give people, and they just love them. So you just start at the top, wrap it, working your way down the pen, and you're going to keep the cap on for now because you kind of want to see where the cap ends up. And I'm going to eyeball it so it looks about right there. So you can put the cap on the side, roll the floral tape down, pulling as you go, because what happens when you pull it is it makes it sticky and it tacks to itself. Once you get to the point where you know that it's going to be, you start going back up towards the top. And you can go a couple of times around the hump that is created from the flower, because sometimes it will poke through, but sometimes it's nice like this one. And just pull it, seal it, because you pulled it, it got tacky. Put the little cap back on. And there you go. A very pretty pen for people to use during the baby shower or wedding, bridal shower. Very simple, very inexpensive, and very well liked. Have a good day. Bye.